Rendezvlog. That is a G chord, and this is a guitar that's out of tune. So why the G chord? I've been watching some stuff on the internet. I've been dabbling in internet philosophy, understanding past, present, and future. Did I lose you? My room is still a fucking mess from making the April Fool's Day video. So here on the channel, and with toy collecting, we deal with nostalgia. Now, nostalgia is like a concept that everyone understands, but is kind of hard to define, but it nonetheless is interesting. How do we understand the past without anticipating the future while remaining present? You still with me? I guarantee that this whole Monday vlog is just going to turn into a weird, nebulous conversation about nothing, trying to deal with the past, the present, the future. But these are the things that are rattling around in my skull these days, and these are the reasons why you've been subscribed for as long as you have. Let me demonstrate. Humor me. Hit the like button. Here we go. Old chord organ. Past, the present, and the future. How do we really appreciate a melody or a song without acknowledging the notes that came before it, the note we're currently standing on, and the note that we're anticipating? So the G... is it the right way around this time? On its own, just the G note, but in a melody, in a musical story, if you will, in a lifetime, the G is meaningless without the note that came before it and the note that we're anticipating to come after it. It gives everything context. We wouldn't have nostalgia without context. And I've been dabbling a little bit in ontology, and I watched a thing about hauntology. And hauntology is sort of an acknowledgement of the present, a understanding of the past, and then a future that never arrived. Again, no expert, just doing a little internet dabbling. It was sort of coined as a result of studying Marxism and socialism. So all of these big, bold claims and promises, and then a future that never actually happened. And in relation to science fiction, it's kind of interesting with these promised futures, these sort of retro aesthetics, these retro futures, where they almost feel nostalgic in a way. It's definitely been suggested to me by the algorithms because of how much I enjoy sci-fi in general, but it's interesting and it's fascinating, and I want to try to find a way to quantify this and apply it to toy collecting, because there's definitely that in the present moment. We have all of these toys as collectors that didn't exist when we were kids, and they're amazing representations of characters we know and love, and they lack any real value without that acknowledgement of the past, and also our own anticipation of the future from the past. Am I making sense? Am I rambling? Yes. So I don't really know how to, like, close this out. I don't really know how to end this video, and it's not really a vlog. I'm kind of just ranting about pseudo-philosophy. But these, again, these are the things that are rattling around in my skull. These are the thoughts that I've been having, and I don't know how to quantify them. I don't know how to package them up nicely, and I don't know how to explain myself. It's also dawning on me that I turn 30 in, like, less than a week, and maybe that's why I'm having an existential crisis. What I'm trying to say is I love toys, I think, and that nostalgia isn't one specific thing. It's this sort of, like, sliding scale of distant memories and future projections. Like, all the things we dreamt of and imagined when we were kids. There's a prime example sitting somewhere here in my toy pile, where when I was a kid, I used to play with my Jurassic Park toys, but I'd turn all the Jeeps upside down, and I'd pretend I was playing Fallout. Now, in the present, I have a toy I anticipated from the past, which is this Glios guy here, which is even in a correct scale, because when I was playing with my Jurassic Park vehicles all overturned, I was using my Star Wars Power of the Force 90s ass figures to be Vault Dwellers and Brotherhood of Steel members, etc. So after a long hauntological and ontological rant about philosophy I don't fully understand. It comes full circle and it comes back to toys, and I feel like I've just rambled for maybe half an hour, but you're probably only going to see like 3 minutes of footage from it. But that's what I've been thinking about lately. That's what I'm trying to wrap my head around. Is he rambling? He's rambling. So maybe it's a question I need to ask. How does your present in toy collecting, your present moment in toy collecting, relate to your past? And then how does your projections of the future from your past give you closure? There is no closure. It just goes on and on, and we just keep collecting forever. I think if anything comes from this fucking weird vlog I've just made, is just maybe think about your present, your past, and your future, and think about the toys that you love and collect, and how does it make you feel? It makes me feel really fucking good. And on the subject of future projections, book club, we're reading Neuromancer. The book club has changed and evolved. It is a much more casual experience. So if you're reading Neuromancer, or you have read Neuromancer, please hop on the book club and let's talk about it. I'm a little bit behind, but that's the new theme of the book club. That's our new slogan. I'm a little bit behind. So I'm probably just going to chill out and read some book today, and I hope you guys are having a lovely day, and I hope all of the rambling that I've done here has given you something to think about, some food for thought. So don't forget to hit the like button. Don't forget to comment and call me a fucking weirdo, because this video is kind of weird. And I'll see you guys very soon, I'm sure. Bye-bye.